Welcome back in this session. Variable in Terraform. So how to define variable, how to use variable, and what is the importance of variable, that we'll discuss in this session. So basically Terraform script divide in three different sections. One is the main script, where the main resource are going to create. Another is variable scripts, where the variables are defined. And the third one is the output script, where all your output are kept. So this is not the Terraform given the any recommendation, but this is the industry recommendation that we should use a certain structure. You can make your own structure, no issues, but this use will be more easy and with more manageable in terms of Terraform execution. So Terraform use the variable to hide secrets. So the key point is that I cannot give my username and credentials detail in variable, that we should make such where we can hide the secrets, that we will see in next slides. The next one is variable value change as per region. So why variable is required? Because in some case region are getting changed. In some case the values are differ from the different accounts, kind of production account having the different instance type, or the QA or a dev account having the different instance type. So we have to use variable where variable can understand, and variable will pass the value based on the your account and based on your region. So the condition should map with the proper case. So this is a sample where we have used the provided details. In the provided details we have passed the access key and secret key. So this is not recommended where you are directly exposing your access key and secret key. So in case you have given this case, so it will be open for the all who knows your code. So we should hide these things using the variable. So we can use the variable like this, where we refer the variable for the region, for the access key, and for the secret key. So we have to use the variable where the variable are kept the different where, and the main script are kept the different where. So both having the different reference. So main thing is here the provider having the reference only, no variable defined over in main script. So how do we define variable? So we create one variable.tf file. In that variable.tf file, we'll create the variable as per the given example. That's access key, secret key, and region. So here I didn't give any input for the access key and secret key. So that's a blank value. So the blank value will be passed from the tfvars. So at tfvars, I have created one more file where the tfvars having the value of access key and secret key. I kept here blank just because of the showing, but the same will be filled up in the demo section. But you can understand that the TF bar having the access key value, secret key value, and region value. You can make your region value over here, but and the variable.tf having the region value will be override. So if you pass from the TF bars, it will be override from the variable.tf. So by default, if I am not giving the any region value in tfvars, that default will be taken as the US East one. But access key and secret key, that we have to pass from the tfvars. So tfvar will not be directly exposed to the code, because we will keep the in gitignore file. So gitignore file will not make the commit for the terraform.tfvars, because tfvar are kept as a secrets for Terraform. So this we'll see in next session, how to use this completely variable reference and TFRs, that we'll completely understand in next demo section. Welcome back in this session. Variable demos. We'll see variable demos in this section. So let's see the scripts over here. So I created a script here, that's AWS instance creation. So this is my main script. Here you can see that I created a script. We are only instance creation resources there. So no variables, no providers. So you can see I just kept that AMI, where I do lookup with the AMI ID and region that we'll see. So let's open the provider here. So in provider TF, I have created provider TF is having the variables defined reference. So region having the where dot region reference and access key and secret key having the different reference. So here the we didn't pass anything static value. So where we have passed the static value, that let's see. So we have created one more file, is variable.tf. So in variable tf file, you can see the access key and secret key I made the kept here blank. So this variable having the no values by default. So variable region having the by default value is the US East 1. But I have made for the mapping here. So I created one AMI ID that we have used here in instance AMI ID. So in AMI ID is the variable type is map. We can use the different variable types. I have kept here the variable type is map. So map having the region and the AMI ID. So there are two mapping. One is the region name and one is the AMI ID. So these two having different. So in here in lookup have where.AMI ID will be passed based on the region. So if I have given the pass the variable region having the US East 1, it will take the US East 1 AMI ID. Now let's see the where we have kept the secrets. So secrets having the cat, the TFRs. So TFRs having the secrets key and access key that I kept the secretly in different files. So all this having the integrated the solution with the one single instance. So how this secrets key and access key are secret, let's see. So I'm seeing that my Git repo here, and in Git repo you can see here only three files is there. That's a AWS instance example, provider.tf and variable.tf. No TFRs file available here. So that will be stored at locally and it will work as a local. So let's run a script here. So I'm running the Terraform plan here. So this will identify the what things are going to change and what resource are going to create. So you can see there is a one resource are going to create, and let's make the Terraform apply. So Terraform apply will be create the resources based on the secret files pass credential. Okay, we have kept two times enter, that's why we have to pass the confirmation when it will ask. Okay, we have to pass the confirmation, yes, then it will start the applying. So now we have given the confirmation for the applying, and now apply will be start the creation of the AWS instance. You can see it started here the creation of the AWS instance. So this is the how things are working with the variables passing through variable.tf, and credential are passing through the tf.tf vars. So it might take some time because it will wait for the complete checks which done by the AWS. All the checks are done, and until unless the DNS and IP will not get instance, it will wait for the final confirmation. Okay, my resource are created here, and this is the variable example how it works.